Today is day number 6 of our Florida Road Trip 2021. It is June 23rd and we are going to Magic Kingdom for the first time. We took an Uber there so we didn't have to deal with driving or paying the parking.
So when do we check in? Are we getting in the park?
Yeah.
The parking lot is about 1 mile from the theme park. There's only three ways to get there. You can either take the ferry boat, you can ride on the monorail, or you can walk along the trail. We took the ferry boat. I'll put the link to that video in the description. When you get to the other side of the Seven Seas Lagoon, you have to walk through the entrance. Here's where you would either scan your Magic Band or your card that has your ticket on it. Magic Kingdom Park opened October 1st, 1971. The park was built over tunnels so the cast members could move through the park without being seen. Because of the Florida's high water table, the tunnels were built on existing grade and the park was built on the second story. Once you get into the park, you walk into Main Street, USA. Upon entering the park, we get greeted by Mickey, Minnie, Pluto, Daisy, and other cast members. Main Street USA is turn of the century. You'll first enter the town square, complete with the city hall, which is actually guest services, and there is even a fire station. Next to the fire station is Harmony Barbershop. It is a real working hair salon where haircuts, beard, and mustache trims are also offered. You can get a baby's first haircut with a certificate to remember the magical moment. The firehouse is Engine Company 71. The 71 is for the year that it opened. The decor and stories are from fire departments in the early 1900s, replicas of early fire trucks. Uber Eats and some of those foods. Next door to the fire department is the barn containing the horse-drawn trolley. It used to be used to pull people around the park. Everything always continues on the theme. This store is made to look like it is from the turn of the century. Casey's Corner offers American baseball favorites such as hot dogs, corn dog nuggets, french fries, soft drinks. Continue around the corner and there it is, Cinderella's Castle. I purchased the photo pass package when I bought our tickets, so we did have some fun photos taken. Next, we headed to Tomorrowland. Tomorrowland was originally designed to portray Disney's view of the future. The problem with that is that it needed to be frequently updated. In the 1990s, Disney chose a different way and renovated Tomorrowland to look like the future that was described by the sci-fi writers from the 1920s and the 1930s. This was the future that never was. If the Coca-Cola cool ship for strangers feels familiar to you, it might be because it was originally in the movie Flight of the Navigators. It was used as the ship. Tomorrowland Speedway is a gas-powered car driven down an enclosed track. I will be uploading the video of this experience in the near future. That way, right?
What? What?
Next, we go to Fantasyland. Fantasyland is based on Disney's classic animated films. The Storybook Circus features Goofy as the Great Goofini, Dumbo the Flying Elephant, also the Fantasyland station on the Walt Disney World Railway. Over here. There's a cavalcade coming through with carriers. Here is a look at Cinderella's castle. There will be future uploads of other videos from Edgy Kingdom. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new to this channel, please hit the subscribe button and ring the notification bell. Thank you.